30 amps. This is 35, but they say it should work. They just don't recommend it because of heat. So this is a power, and here we go. Battery, two batteries. This is, it's gotta be to the battery. This battery, which I guess it comes out. I don't know where the connection is. I see only one hole. Problem with that going to go in there. It's gonna fit.
Okay. It's a separate, it's an aftermarket battery, so okay. Don't look at this as
okay,
part
so just a bike.
Yeah, this is just a separate, it's cheaper though.
Okay.
I mean, this is like $400.
Okay.
And so forth, so.
Oh, okay, the battery, okay. How much was the bike altogether?
$2,200.
Okay.
With tax. Free shipping.
Oh, free shipping?
Yeah.
Oh.
And they're out of Southern California. They're out of Southern California.
Okay.
So it's not like you're buying overseas, right? Yeah, yeah, go for it. Yeah, yeah.
I've been wanting to get another one for a minute, you know what I mean?
This is really good. It's got, this can go, I can get this about to 34 miles an hour.
So from Tracy?
Tracy.
So from Tracy to where I work in Pleasant is 30 miles. So that means I would have to get another battery. So if I can get 30 miles there, I can get 30 miles back.
30 miles, yeah, I mean, you're pushing to the limit. I mean, there's
so,
a lot of hills.
Let's say I don't use the battery for
well,
a few miles.
What they say is if look, going at the lowest pedal assist, they say 75, but I don't believe that you can, not with hills.
Okay, wonder if I can recharge it at work.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, you yeah,
just,
yeah.
Cool. I mean, you have to carry your
my
charger
car,
or get
yeah.
a second charger, yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get 22 and then 400 for the battery.
22. You don't need this battery if you don't want it. But if you want to, that's an additional $400 or $500.
Yeah, I'm just going to get it, though, just in case if I need it. You know what I mean?
Of course.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, I'm glad I seen you. I'm glad I seen your bike, man.
Yeah.
I've been looking for one. I want to see it physically. My buddy, he's over out in Modesto. I mean,
Yeah.
I saw his Fresno.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So I really hadn't seen it. Billy sent me a picture.
Yeah, yeah.
So I hadn't really seen it.
Like, this is, I'm telling you, price-wise, this is probably the best per dollar.
Okay.
Per speed. And for what you get in return.
Okay.
It's one of the quickest ones for the price. Not, there's obviously faster bikes, but you're paying double,
for the price.
At least double. Like the Grizzly I just mentioned is the top of this bike. That's running 3,800.
Okay.
This is 2,200.
Okay.
I think it's on sale right now at 2,200.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone rides it. All right. Take care.
So I thought I'd do a couple of things. I just upgraded the battery. Or I'm sorry, I added a battery. It's temporary. I've ordered some new straps. So it should be coming in tomorrow or today. So I have another footage that I already made a recording of. But basically these two batteries are connected here into a connector that's called a blender. It's made by Spark Cycleworks. And the controller and this battery all have the XT60 connector, okay? So I don't know if I mentioned that in the previous portion of this video, but so that's pretty much it. I just connect all of them into that one little blender. It's called a blender, and then you got battery for double the range. Additionally, I just wanted to cover a couple other things that I thought was kind of cool that I found. Was this connector right here. This connector allows me to swap out the camera relatively easily, you know, so this connector I thought would be kind of cool. This comes in a packet where you can connect it to like a GoPro. This is like a connected, this part right here is just connected to I don't know what they're called, those, you know, basic screw-on things that's typically on tripods. But one of the reasons I liked about this, this is one part of two pieces. The other piece would be this part right here, if you can see. I'm not sure if I'm pointing it right, but that camera, I'm sorry, this piece is connected like in a GoPro connector. And what that allows me to do is put this camera that I'm using right now to swap out seamlessly between different parts of well, you know what I'm trying to say, right? Here, so I can swap this I can put the camera in here by just simply twisting, and on the bottom of it is magnetized, so you basically, it connects and then you just twist. And the same thing's true here. I just would connect it here and then twist, and then I got myself a camera on my helmet. And I didn't put it on my 360 camera because I think if I put that plastic piece here, I think it might make this uninvisible, you might say. So I think it sticks out too much. But I do want to point out something else I did. I've been looking for this or something like this for a very long time. Check this out. It's a magnetic connector that powers devices. Now keep in mind this cable, I'll put all the stuff in the description, but basically all this this is one cable, but the cool thing about this is it bends. You can straighten it, bends, but another thing is it twists too, so it'll always fit wherever angle you want. I thought that was really cool. And the reason I got this is so it doesn't stick out. This is a USB right here. If you can see it over here, is a little device that's connected through the type C connector, right? And that's where you normally would use a cable to charge it up or data up, basically. Keep in mind this cable is only for power, not for data, because of the magnetic thing. Obviously can't transmit data, but it does power up this camera. As you can see, you might even be able to hear it when I disconnected and then reconnected. All right, so I thought that was kind of cool, and it kind of makes it invisible too, basically. Anyway, so I just thought that was kind of cool too. All right, so anyway, let's look at this battery again. I did 5 miles, and I'm going to do 5 miles back. And obviously, this is the charge port right here for the battery. And I'll put the description of this thing on the YouTube channel, or actually on this description. So that way, if you like this, I want to get a different strap for this. Anyway, that's about it. That's all I kind of wanted to show you. So far so good. I mean, I'm going to plan on doing a trip later that will allow me to do at least one way is like 25 miles. So round trip should be about 50. I'm going to do that maybe next week or so forth. So then we'll really do the test on this. But yeah, so right now we're just doing kind of a test of the battery itself. I didn't think there was going to be any problem, but just in case. But you can see, it covers up pretty well. I mean, I got that cable right here. You can see from the battery. I mean, I can't see another way to go into it without drilling. But if I do drill, well, I'm not going to drill, to be honest. I think this is fine. If I'm concerned, there is a little air going in there, so I guess that's good to cool that blender connector, because it's supposed to be cool when it's being used. But anyway, that's it. That's for all I got right now. But I just thought that I just wanted to point out this cool device. I thought that was kind of cool, and I particularly like this too. Like I said, I'm going to mount another one of this on the front of my van, or on my dash of my van, and so I can just pull the camera whenever I want, put it on some other device without hassling with the connectors, this part. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put here, because I kind of want to see what the real mileage is. I noticed I didn't notice any additional power, maybe a little more torque. That, I'm just saying, I'm not even sure I feel that. But I do want to see what kind of mile speed I have on this. Because this says I think I was going up to like 34 miles an hour. I have made it up to 37. Slightly going downhill, but I've got it to about 34 today. So anyway, that's it. I got a new helmet, by the way, if you noticed. It's really comfortable compared. I used to own a lot of the Scorpions and the HJCs, but most of them are modular. This one is not. This is what's the MX9, I think, Adventure. The Adventure is only, so it has a shield, and I got the photosynthesis, or whatever it's called, the darkening shield too. But that's, I bought that as an add-on. I think it looks kind of good. Doesn't really match my outfit, I guess, but who cares, right? Just as long as it's comfortable, and for me, it's really comfortable. So anyway, that's it. Let's go riding. Okay. Actually, I'm going to try and mount it on the helmet right now, see how hard it is. Shouldn't be too hard, I don't think. Should be okay. Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. Thank you. Oh, shit.
Look what happened here.
Shit. Actually, you know what? Damn it. I completely forgot. I need to tighten my handlebar. Yeah, this aftermarket stuff sometimes don't work as well as I hope. So I bought this to stem. And the original one didn't allow a vertical 90 degrees, so I thought this was better to raise the handlebar just slightly, you know. We'll see if this may not work out as I'd hope, you know, cheap Chinese product. Of course, the other part was Chinese too, probably, so seemed pretty good, but for the price, I guess. Yeah. Let me put the phone on here because I'll forget completely. And let me put this on so I can get some kind of this road is bumpy as hell, so there's obviously a lot of construction going on too, so all right. Alright.
Alright, so looking at this, I've put so I can do my average. Right, so how many miles did it put on there? I'd say it put 20 miles.